because everything we have heard seems to indicate, and I want to emphasize, seems to indicate, that this happened over a relatively short period of time, whether it was a few years or a year, it happened very quickly, that they went from being normal, all-American kids, even more recently, the younger brother out partying, having fun with his friends, and then all of a sudden becomes a jihadist. Does this happen just from the internet?
It doesn't. I don't think that the older brother was recruited just from the internet. The latest information confirms my suspicion that, in fact, there was a person who recruited and began indoctrinating the older brother. Mm. But I just want to say that when I was recruited into a cult in 1974, it took 2 weeks for me to drop out of college, quit my job, donate my bank account, and believe that the Messiah was on earth. So, yes, it can happen very fast.
I mean, that's incredible you say that. It just brings to mind Catherine Russell. You know, we've shown pictures of her in high school, a student, graduating college. She wanted to join the Peace Corps. Those were her goals. That's her then. She changed dramatically to marry Tamerlan Tsarnaev. She dropped out of school. She started wearing the headscarf, the hijab, converted to Islam. She changed her life, had a baby instead right. of finishing college. Is that, I mean, some people might say, you know what, that's the choice some people make. That's healthy.
Erin.
But is it healthy or not?
It's a stereotypical scenario of an undue influence situation, in my opinion. And what people don't understand is that intelligent, educated people can be deceptively recruited incrementally often with hypnosis, with different mind control techniques such as behavior control, information control. Hmm. Phobias can be installed in people's minds very fast and systematically, step by step. No one in my 36 years of experience says, I want to join a destructive cult and blow up people. But people do fall in love with people, and then they recruit them and indoctrinate mm-hmm. them, or they meet a comrade, and step by step, they get indoctrinated, and then family members and friends witness this personality change, but then are frozen because they don't know what to do to help their loved one.
So the thing that I haven't been able to get my mind around at all, among many things, but one of them is how the younger brother, Jahar, 19 years old, goes back to school, goes to the gym, goes to parties, is in his dorm for 3 days after these attacks. In fact, he's even there Thursday when the video comes out, as if nothing happened. That's what everyone says, as if nothing had happened. How is that possible? He had just killed people.
It's very, very understandable if you understand the paradigm of dissociative disorder with a cult identity that suppresses the person's real identity. And if he was instructed by his brother, the indoctrinator, to go back to school and pretend like nothing's happened and act normally, then he's going to go back to school and act normally. Completely stereotypical behavior, in my opinion.